happened on that day, and others are saying. They don't understand it, so they mock it. They're full of sweet wine. What is it saying to us this morning? I just want to remind you that that same spirit that fell on the day of Pentecost fills the lives of every believer. And we have the Holy Spirit, and certainly we need to be refilled over and over and over. So what I'm asking is not a recreation of the day of Pentecost. What I'm asking is that we would yield ourselves to the Spirit that we already have. And when we do that, we'll see some things that we've never seen before. And so that is my prayer. Father, I come in Jesus' name. Lord, as we move deeper in your word, help us to understand that the Holy Spirit is God. You told Jesus, but Jesus left and says, I go to prepare a place for you. And he says, he was going to send the Comforter, the Paracletos, another of the same kind. So this morning, God, we have heard of falling in the Spirit of God on the believers there in Jerusalem. We pray right now that your Spirit will fill us, revive us, move us to a place where we are in total obedience to you. Lord, help us to not be as the Gentiles, Lord, who seek signs and wonders. But help us to seek you more than anything. We thank you for the language that you've given us. We thank you for understanding and clarity. Thank you most of all for empowering every believer to live a life of obedience and holiness and righteousness unto you. But as we leave this place, continue to remind us who we are. Help us to glory not in our flesh. Help us to serve one another. Pray with one another. Grieve with those who are grieving. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Doing all these things by the power of your Spirit that indwells us. In Jesus' name. Here this morning, and you have never given your life to Jesus.